Capital Sports Update, where sports is taken seriously.
We are deliberately taking steps to demystify this game. It is a people's game. It's a game you can play alone. Because you don't play against somebody, you play against the course. It is a mental game. Golf teaches you very, very many useful life lessons. For people who wonder, why do people play golf? What is it about beating a ball and following it the whole day? You should ask yourself, what is it that those people see in that game which makes them play it? You should ask yourself, what is it that golf teaches people that makes your big corporate types, everyone you call rich, plays golf? Ask yourself why. There's a reason, there's a lesson to be learned there. Yeah. So we are hoping to demystify this game, to demystify this sport. And as you can see, the cost of playing golf has been coming down over the years. And we are not going to define golf strictly in terms of the big clubs, which are expensive. We will not define golf in terms of Karen Country Club. We will not define golf in terms of Modaiga Golf Club. We want to define golf in terms of 43 other golf courses in this country, including the newest I know of, a golf range which opened in Gashoka, in Mbere, last month. Yes, and I'll be trying it this weekend myself. So that's what we want. We want little kids in the villages out there to realize this, oh, by the way, there's another game called golf. It's a funny game. You know, there's sticks and balls and something happens there. We want to develop this interest. Because tomorrow's champion, you don't see them today. They're in some dusty village somewhere in Kwale. Yeah. And over the course of the next 2 weeks, they will be watching KTN somewhere, TV, and they will see, hey, by the way, there's this game called golf. And they will have an uncle who works in Diani, and one day they'll go to Leisure Lodge Golf Club and say, can I see what you do here, uncle? And that is your next champion 20 years from now. But first, that champion needs to see and be inspired so the thought can enter his head so that he or she can start preparing for it. So we're making an investment into the future. And Kenya as a sporting destination, going forward, we are a powerhouse in Africa. But you don't become a powerhouse by sleeping on your laurels. You become a powerhouse and you remain a powerhouse by staying sharp. Stay sharp. Push the envelope. Stay sharp. The potential for sports in bringing people together and advancing a nation's agenda is very, very clear. It's also a form of soft power. Kenya is a global superpower. In what? Not military terms, not economic terms. If you ask anyone from anywhere in the world, what are Kenyans famous for? Running. You'll be told you're famous for running. But not enough focus is placed on the people who make all this happen. So as Vision 2030, we're interested in the people. We're interested in the human interest story. So we decided to come in and sponsor the players and their caddies as well. The reason for this is because, as many people will tell you, golf is a mental game. It's a very mental game. You can have all the talent in the world, but if your mind is not settled, you'll not play a good game of golf. And what we want to do is to use this as an example to our local corporates and our local philanthropists. Support these people. Don't just wait until they are now at the top of the game. They have brought themselves there by hook or crook using their own steam. And then we want to come in at the end to claim the glory. No, we want to get to a point where these sportsmen and their sporting potential is realized and harnessed. Branding rights, you know. We want these people to become sports ambassadors. We want them to be like Eliud Kipchoge and Isuzu GM. We want them to be like Bridget Koskei and Stanbic. We want to hear next week it is David Waku and Bidco. We want to hear next year it is Samuel Njoroge and East Africa Breweries. So we want these people to be sponsored by our local corporates. Pick up these gentlemen. Don't just wait until they make it to the Kenya Open. Pick them up, support them through the Safari Tour events, give them foreign exposure, and then when you get your reward, eventually, when your player tees up and 500 million people are looking at your brand, that's your return on investment. So we are making a specific, wanted this to be like an example, an encouraging example to our corporates. Come in, support these people. The return on investment you get from any one of these players, like when they make the cut, even locally in Kenya, whoever makes a cut becomes a national hero. We are hoping that all of them will make the cut. They can do it. This is Kenya, this is our course, this is our country. All these visitors are coming here. They need to come and find that this place has its own sphere. Kenya iko na wenyewe pia. Kenya na wenyewe. So, and also we don't want our players to be scared by big names. You know, the big names you see in the European Tour, etc. No, no, no. When you stand and you tee up, you're equal.